Mr. and Mrs. Jones are in a doctor's office. They are trying to genetically alter an embryo so that their child will have the traits they want it to have. You see, both Mr. and Mrs. Jones are carriers for Tay-Sachs, a fatal genetic disease, and they want to make sure their child is not. However, Mr. and Mrs. Jones have also decided they want a smart daughter with green eyes. They tell this to the doctor. The doctor tells them she would gladly do all of this for the Joneses, but warns that by changing one gene, you never know what else could change. For example, she could alter a gene related to intelligence, but as a result, the child would be more sensitive to pain. The Joneses think about it.
Outside of the doctor's office, there is a protest. Michael, one of the protesters, had a sister who was genetically modified to act as a savior sibling to his brother. His brother was born with a rare and fatal disease, and his sister was born to provide the necessary tissues that would save his life. However, his brother still died, leaving his sister feeling purposeless and depressed. Eventually, her depression reached a point where she felt she could no longer live anymore, and she committed suicide. Although Michael understands that his parents would have done anything they could to save his brother, he wishes they would never have engineered his sister in order to spare the emotional trauma his entire family had to go through as a result of the death of both of his siblings.
Michael found comfort through his good friend and priest, Father Williams, who is deeply troubled by the idea of genetically altered children. Father Williams considers modifying the DNA of embryos playing God, and thinks that humans should not have that kind of power. He thinks procedures like this remove the position of marriage in society. He worries that the practice will become widespread, and with that, a race of people who all look and act the same. He believes that uniqueness and individuality are an integral part of the human experience. He also worries that a new class system will be created in which the genetically enhanced people will rule over the normal people. For all these reasons, he does not support the selection of a child's traits.
Father Williams' sister-in-law, Nora, disagrees with him. Nora is a transhumanist who believes we can, and should, improve the human condition through the use of advanced technologies. She thinks that the human species is devolving to become less intelligent and that the only way to counteract that is to modify the genes of an embryo. She argues that selection of traits can not only rid humans of their faults, but also improve them as well. She learned about this from her roommate in college, who later became a doctor and specializing in altering the genes of embryos for potential parents looking for that service.
The doctor was currently consulting Mr. and Mrs. Jones, who were about to reach a conclusion on whether or not to genetically alter their child. Mr. and Mrs. Jones have decided that the only modifications they will make on their child is to ensure that it does not have Tay-Sachs. They will leave everything else to chance. They have decided that the risk is far greater than the possible gain, and that they would not want their child to have to live with something that they caused by modifying its genes. They will love their child no matter what it looks like. The doctor agrees to make sure that the Joneses' child will not have Tay-Sachs and do nothing else to it. Mr. and Mrs. Jones leave the doctor's office.